skull graven in the floor.
In his palace through the door.
Even in an enlightened world,
we still flock to feel close to God. Do you believe in God?
God's not who I came here to find.
G-D won't do a G-D damned thing to answer anybody's prayers.
Answering prayers is complicated. Too much work, it's inelegant. Otherwise, he'd do it all the time.
Allowing bad things to happen just for one reason, and that is the magnificence.
More elegant than stopping the universe, preventing an earthquake or the adverse, putting out fires or curing cancer. If it isn't elegant, just let them suffer. Those are the rules that define the conditions of his design.
You talking about God or Hannibal?
Hannibal isn't God.
Wouldn't have any fun being God.
But defying God, that's his game. The station of every train of thought he pursues, he would be thrilled to see. The roof collapse and choir sing, mid-mass with packed pews, and he thinks God would love it too. In the frescoed walls of his mind, far and complex, dark and light, miles of corridors us he led to his palace reconstructed. This isn't just Hannibal, it's where he begins. Wonderfully, fearfully.
Why fearfully?
Against the physical world, he's well armed. But beyond that, there's land charred. Places within himself, he can't safely go. We can reach for them. Once we know, we can find him.
Chief Investigator Rinaldo Pazzi, Questura di Firenze.
You're a long way from Florence.
You're a long way from Baltimore. I've read all about your incarceration.
Keep reading. I was acquitted.
You've been spending a lot of time here.
I've been praying.
A great comfort in praying, the unshakable feeling that we're not alone.
Is Will Graham here because of the body? Or is the body here because of Will Graham?
Why are you here?
I'm like you. I do what you do.
We share the gift of imagination.
I've got the scars of a man who grabbed his gift by the blade.
And yet for your gift you pray. Consider that moment, the synaptic spasm driving through the red fumes when a connection is made.
Knowing. You know who murdered that man and left him in the Capella Palatina.
So do you.
I met him 20 years ago.
Il Mostro was his alias. The monster of Florence makes death look Renaissance.
I still see his tableau peripherally.
Left no fluids, no fingerprints. Not a shred of evidence.
His crimes stay in your head, leave you drowning in dread.
the monster of Florence bore his claws and left La Primavera drawn in blood. Flowers bloomed for him to nip at the bud. Every day bodies dropped with a thud. The monster of Florence opened his jaw. The beast had to eat. He showed no mercy. He's come back home to feast.
Stalking silently from the Uffizi Gallery.
At the Uffizi Gallery, that's where you met Il Mostro?
That's where I met this man.
From success comes inspiration. From this image comes revelation. Blurred and then suddenly clear. He spent his days painting fear. In the gallery, a triumph of mine, to stare at Primavera and find a young man by the Botticelli, transfixed as Il Mostro could be. Before me, I could guess he would recreate the art in the flesh. That was my epiphany. Glorious until it ruined me.
In haste and heat of passion, the Questura nearly destroyed the young man's home trying to find evidence.
He doesn't leave evidence.
No, he doesn't.
He eats it.
I'm beginning to understand that for his crimes another man took the fall of perfect suspect. All in character, not evidence.
Blame has a habit of not sticking to Hannibal Lecter.
It has a habit of sticking to you.
Once we're alone, I splinter. Send me